Despite the measures we have put in place, we are already witnessing a phenomenon where the virus is increasingly moving to counties. I think in the last few days you've seen the numbers in the different counties are on the rise. The virus is now domiciled across the length and breadth of our republic, from down south in Kilifi to Mandera in the north, from the west in Vihiga to Kitui in the east. Fellow Kenyans, we have been able to disaggregate the number of cases by county, and this is information that we'll be sharing with you. And just as an example, we have about 101 cases in Nairobi, 34 in Mombasa, 10 in Kilifi, 6 in Mandera, 7 in Kiambu, 5 in Nakuru, 1 in Kisii, 2 in Kitui, 2 in Laikipia, 2 in Kajiado, 2 in Murang'a, 1 in Homa Bay, 2 in Kakamega, 1 in Nyamira, 2 in Nyandarua, 1 in Nyeri, 2 in Siaya, 2 in Uasin Gishu, 1 in Vihiga, 1 in Kwale. And fellow Kenyans, for further elaboration, it's important to note, once we pick these cases, it's one of two scenarios. We have situations where these cases are tested in the counties, and we have situations where some of these members who are tested are residents of different counties. The reason why we're extrapolating for you the cases by county is to be able to demonstrate to you Kenyans that some of our positive cases are actually Kenyans who've had interaction with different members of the public across the country. Therefore, fellow Kenyans, what this means is that we must work even more closely with our county government to tighten our control measures, to harmonize our responses, and mobilize our people to take an active role in this fight. In this regard, we are rolling out mass testing exercise, taking into consideration the risk profiles of clusters. And as an example, fellow Kenyans, in Nairobi, for instance, we shall prioritize the quarantine centers, hotels, isolation facilities, and hospitals. These form our top four priority in Nairobi. We have also identified different cluster areas, and in the coming week, we shall be able to share with you where these cluster areas are within Nairobi County and in the different counties. As an example, Kibera has been identified, and we shall also have prioritized testing in that cluster. In Mombasa, we are deploying 1,000 testing kits to Kenya Ports Authority, KPA. And this is based on the risk of transmission that has been identified from our monitoring teams. And the same will happen in Mandera and Siaya counties. In total, the first phase of mass testing will see approximately 12,000 testing kits deployed to target areas in the next few days. Fellow Kenyans, cognizant of the measures we have taken in the fight for this disease, we are now witnessing a spike in domestic violence, gender-based violence, and sexual offenses. Fellow Kenyans, I have witnessed within the area that I live in, within this Easter weekend, I actually had neighbors coming to my house to report a case of domestic violence. There's a lady who was severely beaten, and really as a Minister of Health, what we are saying is, now is not the time to engage in disputes and to bend about in terms of conferring domestic violence to our partners. We are also in constant communication with the Gender Violence Recovery Center, that's the GVRC, as well as the National Council on Administration of Justice. And both these two organizations have told us that there's an increase both in the numbers of gender-based violence and also sexual violence. And most of the times it's been noticed that this violence is perpetrated by close relatives and guardians. And therefore, fellow Kenyans, even as we address this between the various government departments, we are calling on Kenyans to focus on fighting the virus and to handle the disputes within the laid down civil structures and devoid of any violence. And we also want to remind everyone that the law has not been suspended and that it will catch up with those who meet violence on others during this period. In the last 24 hours, fellow Kenyans, we have tested 694 samples. Out of these samples, 8 have tested positive for coronavirus disease, bringing the total number of confirmed cases in the country to 216. 5 are Kenyans, and the other 3 are of different nationalities, foreign nationalities. 6 have a history of travel from Dubai, the UK, Pakistan, Zambia, and Comoros. The spread of the new cases with regards to their counties of residence is as follows. Nairobi, 6. Siaya, 1. Nakuru, 1. And in terms of age distribution, the pattern continues. And we're seeing that this disease, fellow Kenyans, is actually affecting the productive members of our society. As it stands today, we have about 5 patients who fall within the age group of 0 to 14. We have 15 to 19 falling to 58% in terms of count. And we have about 64% of our cases falling between the age group of 30 to 59, again affecting the productive quarantine centers, while 2 were picked by our surveillance teams. Over this same period, Kenyans, 1 more person has been discharged from hospital, bringing the total number of recoveries to 41. A total of 2,331 contacts have been monitored, out of which 1,729 have been discharged. 602 contacts are now being followed up at the moment. I thank you.